Basically, you can see that you have three types of product services. On the one extreme, you have product-oriented business models. That is actually still product sales, because you sell the product, but you add a service to it, like maybe financial coverage or maybe a maintenance contract. But the product is still the central thing. Then on the other extreme, you have the so-called result-oriented services. Then you, as a company, you say, well, client, you want to have a certain result, and we make sure that you will have your result. Examples there are copiers that allow you to copy things, but the copier stays totally in ownership with the provider, and the only thing that you have to do as a user is actually, you know, copying. There is a teller mechanism in the copier, and on the basis of that, you pay per print. That's it. And then in between, you have the so-called use-oriented services. There, I think the most prominent example are so-called car-sharing services, where you actually buy access to a car, rather than owning the car yourself. I think it's pretty obvious that product-oriented product services, they are still highly dominating. And I think, why is that? There are a few reasons for that. First of all, we come from a period where the normal way of doing business is making products and sell it to consumers. I think the most important thing is that for many companies, it's really very difficult to change your business model to something totally else.